Okay, hello everyone. Today I want to discuss the laws of reflection, such that how we can experimentally verify the laws of reflection. So for the confirmation of the laws of reflection, we required a plane mirror, softwood fins, which are metallic fins. You see here that these metallic fins are required for this experiment. Similarly, we required a solid support in order to stay upright this mirror here. So support is required. Beside these, we required a protector, a pencil. So in my case here, I take a ballpoint. So you required a pencil for this experiment. Similarly, you also required a meter ruler. Now, to start this experiment, first we have to fix this white paper. So first I want to fix this white paper. Now I am going to fix this white paper. After fixing this white paper, now I am going to first draw the reference lines for this mirror. So first I am going to draw the reference line of this mirror. So this is our reference line. Now take normal to this reference line. Now I am going to draw normal to this reference line, and by joining this normal point we get the normal N. This is the non-reflecting side of the mirror, and this one is the reflecting side of the mirror. Now let's place after this, now let's I am going to draw the incident line, which you may take any arbitrary angle. Let's suppose I am interested in incident angle of 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Let's suppose I am interested in 60. Let's suppose, for example, 55 degree. I am interested in 55 degree. So now join this with the incident point. So now this becomes our incident ray, and this is the angle of incident for the mirror theta I. Now place the support as well as the mirror again on your reference line. Here you see that when we place again this mirror, and by penetrating the pins on the line that we take as a incident line, the image of these penetrating pin would appear in the mirror. So now in line with these two pins, we have to attach or penetrate the other two pins in line with these pins. So after this, I will show you how these pins are in line with each other.
Now this is the second pin, and this one, the first one, I am going to fix it more tight. So in order to take reading, now I will show you how these pens are appears in a straight line. So here you see that these pens are almost, you see here that how these pens are almost in a straight line with the other two pins reflection. So here you see that the image of the first two pins and these two pins, which are real pins, are almost in a straight line. So these two real pins and the image of the first two pins almost in a straight line. You see here that. So now from this, let's now take aside this mirror again and joining these points with the incident point. This is our reflected ray and this is the angle of reflection. Now note this angle of reflection, such that what is this angle? So here you see that 0, 10, 20, 30, 40 and 55 degree. This is our reference line. So the angle of reflection is 55 degree and the angle of incident is also 55 degree. So it means that theta I is equal to theta R. 55 degree is equal to 55 degree, which is basically the experimental confirmation of the laws of the law of reflection, which is the first law of reflection. The angle of incident must be equal to angle of reflection. And the second law of reflection is such that the angle of incident, the angle of reflection and normal to the mirror all lies in the same plane. So you see here that all of these rays, incident ray, reflected ray and the normal, are the angle of the incident line, the reflected ray line and the normal line, all are lying in the same plane. So this is our today experimental confirmation of the laws of physics. I hope you learn a basic idea about this thing.